Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We are engaged in explaining Nitishatakam, written by Bhartrihari, who was the king of Ujjain in Madhya Pradesh almost 2000 years ago. He occupies a prominent place among the ancient poets of Sanskrit literature. He belonged to the eminent tradition of Valmiki, Vyas and Kalidas. In his writing, Bhartrihari had a brilliant quality of thought and imagination. His writing is pithy, compact and original in imagery. There is a remarkable depth in his thinking on subjects as diverse as polity in a civilized society, erotica, and total renunciation. He had an admirably sharp and penetrating wit. In Nitishatakam, Bhartrihari deals with the themes of civic polity, a king's duties towards his subjects, the importance of education in society, the value that ought to be placed on the poets, the philosophers, the savants, the relationship between parents and their children, between husbands and wives and between friends. Nitishatakam is a book of manners for kings and commoners alike, for the learned and the idiots, for the prosperous and the paupers, and for the wise and the fools. Bhartrihari asserts the supremacy of learning over kingly power and wealth. In Nitishatakam, the poet stands taller than the king and has the guts to tell the king to mind his own business. Today's shlokas deal primarily with the qualities of human beings, qualities which make him a better person, humble person, charitable, saintly, a sage. All these shlokas have got excellent eye-catching imagery. The first one reads, Bhavanti namrah taravah falodgamai nav ambubhi bhuri vilambino ghana anuddhata satpursha smriddhi bhi swabhav evaish paropakari nam. Those who benefit others are naturally humble. What a formulation. Those who benefit others are naturally humble. They are of a charitable disposition. They are like a tree that bends low when it is heavy with fruit. Very powerful image. They are like the new water-laden cloud that comes down to shower rain on the earth below. Another image, outstanding. Water-laden cloud comes down, an empty cloud floats on. So a person who benefits others, who has the capacity to benefit others, is naturally humble. The next shloka again deals with the charitable people, their qualities, described in outstanding images. Shrotram suta naiva na kundalena, danena paniha natu kankanena, vibhati kaya karuna paranam, paropakarahi na tu chandanena. Every word has a weight in gold. Bhartrihari could use language according to his brilliance. He says, the charitable, the merciful, do not need ornaments to adorn them with. Not pendants, but listening to the scriptures adds beauty to their ears. Their hands do not need golden bangles. It is charity that lends them luster. Wah, wah, what a thought. It's not bangles which make arms beautiful. It's charity which makes them beautiful. It adds luster to them. Their bodies glisten not because they use the sandal paste, but because they do well by others. And because of their kindly deeds, paropakarehi na tu chandanena. Sandal paste need not be used to make them fragrant. Their fragrance will come from their deeds. The next stanza again talks of such people who not only are good, but who make others good also. And they keep their friends away from misdeeds, rather propel them to do good deeds. Papa anni varayati yojayate hataya guyani guhati gunan prakriti karoti apad gatam cha na jahati dadati kale sat mitra lakshmana lakshanam idam pravadanti santaha. The sages have described the qualities of a sincere friend thus. Here's a new theme. Who is a sincere friend? Bhartrihari says, he who keeps his friend away from misdeeds and propels him to do good deeds. He's an inspiration. He's also a stopcock. He persuades them towards good, weans them away from evil. He covers his friend's weaknesses and highlights his positive attributes. He looks at the positive side of things. In times of distress, he helps his friends and does not desert him when the chips are down. What noble thoughts! A sincere friend does not desert his friend when the latter's chips are down, when misfortune has overtaken the friend. Sincerity in friendship continues. They help their friend. They take them out of depression. They give them succor. Such are sincere friends. And continuing in the same vein, in the next stanza also Bhartrihari talks of saintly people who are ever ready to benefit others, and they do not wait for a request. They are like the sun. Padma karam din karo vikachi karoti chandro vikashayati kairav chakravalam nabhyartito jaldharo api jalam dadati santah swayam par hiteshu krita bhi yoga. The good, the saintly, are ever ready to benefit others, and they do not wait for entreaties. Nobody has to goad them to benefit others. It is inherent in their nature, in their temperament. They are like the sun which makes lotuses bloom. Billions of kilometers away, the sun spreads its rays, his rays, and blooms the lotus on earth. Every morning I wonder, for getting one tiny light in our home, we have to do so much, generate electricity, and here the sun god is distributing everything free all over the world and has been doing so for millions and millions of years. It's a remarkable phenomenon. Bhartrihari compares the good and the saintly people to the sun. There could not be a better comparison. They are like the sun which makes lotuses bloom. They are like the moon that shines so that the water lilies spread their petals. They are like the cloud that showers rain upon earth. Without a prayer, they come. They rain they enrich us with crops, they lower our temperatures, and then they just float away, exhausted, empty, without taking anything from us. Such are the good people about whom Bhartrihari is talking. And in the next stanza, which is the last of this particular video, Bhartrihari again talks of people who help others while sacrificing their self-interest. Eke sat purusha pararth ghatka swartham parityajye samanyastu pararthaṁ udyam bhrita swartha virodheniye temi manush rakshasah parahitam swarthayam vignanti ye nignanti nirarthakam parahitam te ke na jani mahe. Mark the words, mark the thoughts. There is nothing which is second class, all first class. They are the best who help others while sacrificing their self-interest. They sacrifice their self-interest and help others. Those who help others while taking care that their interests are not hurt, they come in the second category. The first category is of those people who don't bother about their interest while helping others. But those who, for selfish ends, make sure that the other person does not benefit, are nothing but evil persons. Yet there are some who hurt others for no reason and are malignant without a motive. Motiveless malignity. Shakespeare's Iago. He wants to harm Othello for no reason, for no justification. Bhartrihari says he does not know how to classify them. They are the scum of the earth. Keep away. But they are there. Nobody can eliminate them. That is how mankind has evolved. So such are the brilliant thoughts of this great poet, writer, and a king who left his kingdom and just moved on to caves near Ujjain, caves which are even today a tourist attraction. And he is writing of things which make sense. It's a remarkable thoughts. Listen to them repeatedly, read them again and again. Every time you would be enriched. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for visiting this site.